Good morning. I welcome all the students, parents, and the dignitaries from VNIT Nagpur to this orientation program for first year BTech BArch students, batch of 2020-2024. I am Ashwin Dawale, the Institute first year BTech coordinator. My role is to assist the Office of Dean Academic in smooth conduct of the first year classes and examinations. We begin this program with director's address. Hence, I request the Honorable Director VNIT, Professor P.M. Padule, to kindly address the gathering.
Thank you, Professor Dawale. All my colleagues who are sitting over here, deans, heads of the department, associate dean, registrar, and my student, first year friends, their parents, I welcome you all for this orientation program in a virtual mode. Normally, for this program, we have got students and parents on a campus, and the atmosphere is full of joy, energy, life. We observe the parents and the students moving in the campus. They are visiting various departments, laboratories, library, sports centers, and other so many things in the campus. But unfortunately, this year, it is not possible because of the COVID-19 pandemic. And therefore, what we thought that we will take you to the campus tour in a virtual mode. And so we have created a small video which will take you to the campus. I hope that you will enjoy that video. And after that video, I will be interacting with you for a few minutes. So let us enjoy that video, please.
And research with the mission of developing global leaders with passion and dedication in engineering, technology, and allied disciplines. Visveshwarya National Institute of Technology, Nagpur, which is popularly known as VNIT, is one of the 31 NITs in the country. It had a humble beginning as a government engineering college in the premises of Government Polytechnic, Nagpur, in 1960. With just three departments. Gradually, it grew into the Visveshwarya Regional College of Engineering and moved to the present campus with an area of 214 acres in 1965. It was then the only premier engineering institute in Central India. In August 2007, Visveshwarya National Institute of Technology, along with other NITs, was declared as the Institute of National Importance by the Act of Parliament. Visveshwarya National Institute of Technology is named after great statesman, planner, and engineer of modern India, Bharat Ratna, Sir Moksha Gundam Visveshwarya. VNIT is situated at heart of Nagpur city. The sprawling, lush green campus of VNIT will surely allure you with its methodical patches of greenery. VNIT has 14 academic departments offering 8 BTech programs and a BArch program at undergraduate level and 19 MTech program, along with 3 MSc programs in applied sciences. All departments also offer full-time doctoral program. More than 5,000 students stay on campus. VNIT is having state-of-art laboratories, well-equipped classrooms, faculty and student accommodation, library and information center, sports facility and health center, which makes it desired destination for education for many aspiring students. Ivy Lab, which is a robotic lab, students of VNIT have developed a robot named Sahayak to help fight during coronavirus pandemic. Sahayak robot can be used by hospital staff to deliver food, packets and medicine to the COVID patients. Center of Excellence titled Industry 4.0 and Digitalization has been established at VNIT in collaboration with Siemens for generating leaders in automation technology for the students to develop industrial skills and competency which will aid them in becoming professionals. Recently, VNIT has commissioned the state-of-art academic building with G+6 floor housing more than 100 faculties and 150 PhD scholars. Recently inaugurated classroom complex has 9 virtual classrooms. Also, girls and boys hostel with 1000 capacity each having separate food court and multi-activity complex is commissioned. 1 megawatt solar plant is installed to reduce carbon footprints. We are celebrating year 2020 as Diamond Jubilee of VNIT as its 60th year of imparting quality technical education. We celebrated Diamond Jubilee inauguration function on 19 January 2020, which was graced by Honorable Shri Nitin Ji Gadkari, Minister for Road Transport and Highway, and the Minister of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises, Government of India. The Diamond Jubilee inauguration function included unveiling of a new bronze statue of Sir Vishveshwarya, beautification of landscaping promenade from main gate to the administrative building, Chandrama Plaza, which is a popular joint for hostel students with a new look by maintaining its original flavor, and also football ground. The year-long celebration of Diamond Jubilee has witnessed various academic, social, entrepreneurial and outreach events which has enhanced the joy of learning and vigor for technical aptitude. The institute has developed number of technologies for the improvement of quality and productivity of the ruler-based activities such as mosquito repellent coil manufacturing machine, ruler blacksmith furnace, biodiesel reactor, modified double roller gin. Outreach activity are an important and valued aspect of every VNITian's responsibility and are an integral part of the VNIT's mission. VNIT donated 3 machines developed by its director, Professor P.M. Padure, to help the rural women to generate resources and self-employment. This project was sponsored by Khadi and Village Industry Commission, also known as KVIC, a statutory body formed by the Government of India. Thank you all for joining us.
I hope that all of you must have enjoyed the video and must have got the fair idea about the institute. However, I will add some more things to it. As has been told to you in the video, that the institute is quite old and is one of the oldest technical institution established in 1960 as a REC, and then they are all converted to NITs, and finally in 2007 they are declared as the Institutes of National Importance by the Act of the Parliament. So very old institution, and we are next. We are having 215 acres of green campus, and we have got about 5,000 students are on campus, and we are providing the 9 UG programs we are running. Then one BH program, and similarly 23 PG programs in the different departments. The VNIT has got a good faculty strength of about 250, which is a good jail of senior faculty members and relatively young faculty members. Next. Some of the academic departments that we are having is listed here. We have got 15 academic departments. Next. When you must have seen that we have got a very good infrastructure. Every department has got good buildings, then hostels are there, laboratories are there, academic block, then classroom complex, which is newly established, the sports complex, and all these things are there, which you must have seen in the video. But one thing which was missing there was, I suppose, the health center. VNIT has got a very good health center. We have got two medical officers which are running it, and then many doctors which are visiting every day. And the student has got the cashless hospitalization facilities and other facilities. Of course, details about that will be talked by our medical officers in the later stage. VNIT, in fact, believes the holistic growth of the students and also imparting a state-of-art knowledge to the students. In this regard, VNIT is trying for having a better interaction and improved interaction with the industries, and the solid collaboration with the internationally known organizations. And we are trying for it. In this regard, recently we have signed some of the MOUs with the different organizations. Some MOUs I am just presenting over here. We have signed an MOU with Dassault Aviation and Dassault Reliance Aerospace Limited, Nagpur. And this MOU will be definitely helping our students. Some of the students, they will be in a position to do their internships and the projects at France and some of the universities in France. Similarly, that also includes the faculty exchange program. Then another MOU that we have recently signed is with AIIMS Nagpur. I'm happy to share with you that VNIT is having a very strong group of the faculty members and research scholars who are working in the area of biomedical engineering. We have got a good biomedical engineering forum, and they have developed a number of technologies, tools, and the implants and other kind of things. So this MOU, I suppose, will further enhance these activities in the area of this biomedical engineering. Next. Similarly, we also signed recently the MOU with Siemens Center, with Siemens Industries, and we are setting a center of Siemens Center of Excellence with a thrust on Industry 4.0. And there will be about 11 laboratories, 6 will be hardware and 5 will be software types. This kind of center of excellence will definitely help our students in the areas of FMS, automation, IoT, and other areas. And it will not only help our students, but this MOU will also be useful for the development of this region, because it will also be helping the industries in and around Nagpur. Then one more MOU, which is of very importance, is signed with the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways recently in New Delhi, and also with Indian Road Congress. I suppose VNIT is one of the NITs who got this opportunity to sign the MOU. This MOU will be helping our students and the faculties for getting the projects and the consultancy in the area of the transportation management, and other things. I am very happy to share with you that our faculty members are, along with their regular academics, they are also involved in various R&D projects. Some of the major R&D projects which the institute is having, they are just listed over here. I am happy that at present we are having more than 140 R&D projects which are costing about more than 50 crores of rupees. Next. And this is continuously increasing in years to come. And as I said, that at present we are having 138 R&D projects, and this R&D projects are definitely resulted into publications in journals and the in the conferences, and this number is continuously increasing. This has also resulted into technology transfers and the getting the patents. I am happy to tell you that as per the India Today, the VNIT is ranked fourth for the patent publications and the first as far as the patent granted is concerned. So I congratulate all my faculty members for this achievement. Next. Then our faculty members and students, they are doing extremely well and they are getting the honor and the awards for this purpose. And some of the awards and the honor that we got, I am just presenting. The VNIT has received the Best Innovation Award, particularly for developing the technologies for the rural sector. And this has been given by the Government of India, KVIC. Then Professor H.M. Suryavanshi of the Electrical Engineering Department is a fellow of IEEE. I'm telling you, these are some of the awards and these things. I'm sure that at the departmental level, when there will be presentation, the department will also be giving more such awards and the honors that the department has received. Shriram Sonone of the Chemical Engineering Department got the award of fellow award for outstanding contribution to the field of engineering and science. Similarly, Dr. Kailash Vasivar, who is also from the same department, has been included in the top 2% scientist in chemical engineering as per the survey of the Stanford University. Dr. Rahul Ralegaonkar also got an award. Mohan Aware got the IETE Binal Bose Award. Mangesh Madhurwar got Young Scientist Award for 2019. There are many such, in fact, the awards and the honors, which has definitely added the feather to our institute. Similarly, our students are also involved in so many activities. Other than the academics, they are involved in competitive examination, various competitions, and they also received good awards and the honors at the different activities. Some of the awards and the notable achievements for the students are just presented over here. Next. I am happy that four of our undergraduate students, they have received the PMRF fellowship, and then two of our teams, they got the first prize in Smart India Hackathon. Then one of our team that got the DST Lockheed Martin Tata Trust Indian Innovation Growth Program, and they got the funding of about 10 lakhs for a new startup. Similarly, the first prize was obtained by the students in Reliance Energy Power Conservation Week. They also won the SBI Yono Quiz Nagpur Regional. A VNIT student, Monish Tikekar, he was selected as a part of Indian youth delegation visited to China. Students of VNIT Nagpur also win Startup Crucible Campus Quiz and they received the prize of 75,000. Then our students' team, it was top three in the Harvard Global Hackathon for the environmental category. So our students and faculty, they are doing quite well and they are also receiving a lot of honors and the awards for that. Our placement of the student undergraduate, it is continuously increasing, and I am happy to share that last year it was 86% of our students who were eligible, they got placed by the institute. Then I will talk about some of the major activities and the events. VNIT is believe in a multidisciplinary research and the activities, and I'm happy to share with you that last year we organized the health exhibition called Kutuhal, and the theme of that was from pre-birth to rebirth. And this 3 days event, it was organized by VNIT along with Indian Medical Association and the other organizations like Vigyan Bharati. And there, in fact, VNIT along with the AIIMS and other medical organizations have organized this event. And the theme of that event was whatever tools, gadgets, instruments and other things are required right from the birth to the end of the life. Those were all exhibited here. And I'm happy to tell you that more than 1.5 lakh students from the various schools and the colleges, they visited this 3 days event. There were more than 150 stalls organized over here. Then as far as sports is concerned, our students are doing quite beautifully. And I'm happy to tell you that the NIT, inter-NIT tournament, which was organized at NIT Jaipur, our college was identified as the overall champion. They got the overall championship there. Similarly, this NIT Nagpur, they have organized inter-NIT faculty and staff cricket tournament. This was done for the first time. And I'm happy to tell you that more than 200 participants were there from the different NITs. And our, of course, NIT stood third as far as the competition is concerned. Next. And then, of course, our students are also organizing every year a Technofest called Axis, which is considered to be one of the largest event in the Central India. Then NIT believe that we owe for the society, and particularly all the NITs and I will say the IITs, they are supposed to contribute for the development of the MSME sector. In this regard, we have taken an initiative and we have organized a meet of all NIT directors on 29th December 2019, I suppose. And the theme of that meeting was role of NITs in the development of the MSME sector. And so that was a good sort of initiative from our side. And I'm happy that as a result of that, we shall be getting over a center wherein the VNIT will be a nodal center and all the NITs will be connected to it. Similarly, we had a guest lecture of Sri Vikram Kirloskar, Chairman and MD of Kirloskar Systems. He talked about the air pollution and the carbon credit. Then we have organized various international conferences. One such is by a Mechanical Engineering Department in 2020 as a part of our Diamond Jubilee. Then as a Diamond Jubilee, this year we are celebrating this as a Diamond Jubilee year, and we have got various activities. And I'm happy that to share with you that our alumni has supported it very strongly. And this year, as a part of Diamond Jubilee, the various projects which are costing about 2.5 crores have been sponsored by the various batches of the alumni. One such project was the installation of a 10 feet height bronze statue of, and along with the pedestal of Sir Vishveshwaraya. So that was there. And this all thing was inaugurated by our Honorable Minister Sri Nitinji Gadkari. Then a beautification of our whole campus, particularly from the main gate to main building. This was another project, and there are many more projects. One football, new football ground that was developed, and again it was inaugurated by Nitinji Gadkari. So there are many such projects that we have completed during this year. I'm thankful to our alumni association, which is growing very strongly. Of course, about that, my friend Uday Kamath will be talking more about that next. And then during this COVID-19, we believe that we owe to the society, and during this difficult period, VNIT has contributed to the society by carrying out some of the projects, like a prototype of two-way ventilator was developed here, And by using this single ventilator can be used for two patients, and thereby it will resolve the problem of the scarcity of the ventilator. Then one of my colleagues, he has developed ultraviolet chamber for sanitization of the mask and the PPE, and this was given to the AIIMS Nagpur. Then, as you must have seen in the video, the remotely operated trolley called Sahayak that was developed, this was helpful for serving the food and other things to the patients who are there in the isolation ward. Then we also helped the rural people with pedal operated sanitization machines. Next. As I said, that the BNIT is having very strong alumni, and we have got the distinguished alumni, some of the alumni presenting over here. We have got Padma Shri, Shri Padma Bhushan Vijay Bhatkar, he is our alumni. Then Dinesh Keshkar, who was president of Boeing India, Ramesh Jain, M.S. Unnikrishnan, Pradeep Kar, Dr. B.S. Murthy, who is a director of IIT Hyderabad now. He is also our 1986 alumni. Next. The list is very long. Some of the distinguished alumni I'm just presenting over here. Next. 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 And I'm very happy to share with you that because of the contribution by all the stakeholders, right from our faculty members, industries, then parents and the students and alumni, our NIF ranking is continuously improving. Last year it was 31, and this year we have reached to 27 rank. And I'm sure that with the cooperation of all of you, the next year our NIF ranking will further improve. Then we have got a very unique student mentorship program. About that, of course, my colleague Professor Keskar will be talking in more detail, but here we are having a student mentor under whom there will be 15 students of his branch. And so whatever difficulties normally when the students come to the new institute, he has got some problems. Those problems will be sorted out by this student mentor. And this is a very good scheme, and we are getting a support from TIS Mumbai for further improving this scheme. Next. So these are some of the things that I just wanted to share with you. I'm sure that your stay in the VNIT for 4 years will be very meaningful, fruitful, and you'll enjoy our campus. And I welcome all of you to the VNIT family. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Now I request Dean Academic VNIT, Professor D.R. Peshwe, to kindly brief about the academics in the VNIT and explain about the first year scheme.
Good morning, all VNITians, budding technocrats. I am Professor Peshwe, presently acting as the Dean Academic. I would like to welcome you all for this first year orientation program. Basically, I would like to give you the idea about the academic activities which we are running in the institute. Next slide. In VNIT, we are having a semester program, and basically this particular complete semester program is credit-based system. We run with a two semester programs mostly. We call it as an odd semester or the autumn and winter semester program, which mostly run from July to December. But during this pandemic period of 2021, for you people. Specifically, we are starting it from the 1st December 2020 and it will go right up to the 1st March 2021. The various types of activities which we have planned for all of you. Theory lectures will be distributed from 1st of December to 1st of March. Then we have a midterm examination for you on 18th of January to 22nd of January. Practicals classes will be there at the frag end of the session, starting from 2nd of March to 13th of March, the 2-week program. We will be having an end semester examination from 15th of March to the 19th of March 2021. And those students, those who are not in a position to continue the examination because of the medical reasons, and those who are failing in the main examination, they will be allowed to appear for the re-examination. And the re-examination is scheduled from 25th of March to 27th of March. So we are giving additional chances to the students so that they can clear the examination and go to the next semester without any difficulty. The second semester which we are running for you is basically what we can call it as an even semester or the summer semester, which mostly runs from the January to June every year. But for you, this time in the pandemic period, we will be running for you from the 13th of March to 29th of June. So for you, I'm really sorry that we are not providing any summer vacation to you this time. But within the span of this 7 to 8 months, we would like to finish both these semesters and make you suitable for the next semester, that is third semester admission next year, so that there will be no loss of academic system at all whenever you are graduating from VNIT. So with this aspect, the next semester is also scheduled like this. Theory lectures from 13th of March to 29th of June. Midterm examination from 17th of May to 21st of May. Practical will be again scheduled at the frag end of the semester, 30th June to 10th of July. End semester examination is from 12th July to 16th of July. And as I informed you earlier, the re-examination will be from 22nd of July to the 24th of July 2021. And after this, you will be allowed to take admission into the third semester and you will join the regular program with the higher semester students without any academic loss because of the pandemic COVID, which has created a problem over the admissions for you over this period. Next. As far as the academic systems of VNIT is concerned, we are running with a choice-based credit system. And in the choice-based credit system, you are aware about how the credits are calculated, but let me define to some of the students what is the VNIT system, how credits are defined. Each course or the classes or basically the subjects are classified depending upon how many classes we are engaging per week, and there are certain amount of credits which has been attached to each. One lecture hour per week is having one credit. One tutorial hours per week is also having one credit. And one practical hour per week is also having 0.5 credit. So if there are two practical hours per week, it will be a one credit program. So total credit which is assigned to any course will be the lecturer, tutorial, and a practical together will be giving you a total amount of analysis. And there are certain specialty courses like projects and sports activity related issues where the credit systems are slightly different. And then there are some audit courses which are called a zero credit system, which you are supposed to pass and attend fully. That is essential. Without that, you cannot complete the degree program. Then how these credit systems are calculated, let me give you an example. AML 151, which is one of your course in the first year called as engineering mechanics, which will be having a program distribution like 310, where AML 151 is a course title, or we call it as a course number. Engineering mechanics is a course title, and 310 is actually the distribution of the lecture, tutorial, and practical contact hours. The total number of credits to such type of courses will be, a formula is already given on the screen, and that gives me that AML 151 is a 4-credit program, and AMP, which is nothing but a practical program to engineering mechanics lab, is a 002 requirement, which is a 1-credit program. So like that, majority of the courses are credited and we are running it. in order to give you an idea about what are the basic degree requirement as far as the All India Council for Technical Education and all NITs and IITs consideration, the distributions are given in this particular table for you. The total degree requirement, the credit degree requirement is 170 credits for BTEC program and 219 credit requirements for the architecture program. The distribution has been given here, which has been classified as the basic sciences, engineering arts and sciences, which includes engineering drawing, electrical engineering, engineering mechanics type of courses, workshops even. Then humanities, which is basically the social sciences, communication, then philosophy, psychology, this type of courses are also offered in such type of systems. Then we are having a departmental core. So right from civil engineering to mining engineering, we have a specified core subjects, which is to the credits from 79 to 82 credits. A choice is different because there are for different degrees, there are different type of credit systems specified. Departmental elective, which is where you will get a choice to select the subject as per the specialization, and they will vary from the range of 33 to 48 credits. Then we have some specialty courses like humanities and management, where we have engineering mechanics, engineering economics, and then we have a management programs. So all there you can go and select up to 0 to 6 credit. It is again optional for the students. And then we offer open courses to all the degree students. These open courses are actually any branch course which you would like to select. So a student from mechanical engineering can select a subject from electronics engineering. And that's an option which is available under the category called as open courses. So all this together will try to give you 170 credits for BTEC program and 219 credits for the architecture program in 4 years. Then all the classes at the first year level are divided into two major groups. One is called as the engineering group. Another is called as the architecture group. In architecture, we have an intake of around 78. And we run two sections in architecture, A and B. And every section is having two batches, batch one and batch two. Then in engineering, we have two streams. You are aware because you have already joined this particular stream. We have an intake of 855 plus DASA students, and then there are additional students' admissions. Then there are 5 sections which are basically in the physics stream, classified as W, X, Y, Z, and N. And every section is having 4 batches. Similarly, in the chemistry stream, also we have RST, UL. Where we are having again 4 batches in every section. So we have 10 sections in engineering stream and we have 2 sections in the architecture stream. Next. Just to give you an idea to the parents and also to some of the students, those who have joined the program late, that basically in the physics stream, every student at the first year level has to complete physics stream in the first semester. And some of the students will also complete chemistry stream in the first semester. And then there will be vice versa in the second semester. So physics stream is consisting of engineering mechanics, theory practical, communication skill, mathematics one, engineering drawing theory and practical, physics theory and practical, and a special program about the health information and the sports related activity as a part one in the first semester. And similarly in the part two in the second semester, along with chemistry and chemistry laboratory, computer programming, where we will be giving you a right hands-on experience on the computer systems. Unfortunately, this year you cannot come here, but I am sure all of you will be doing it with our team. Electrical engineering with a laboratory, social sciences, mathematics too, and a very special program on workshop and again health information and sports part two. So this is about the various types of courses. We basically run a 5 days a week program, and Saturdays, Sundays are mostly off. The total timetable has been given to you, and accordingly, you are aware about how the things are happening. But during this pandemic period, we are running timetable as per the schedule which I am showing to you now. We are basically running the program on online, where all the teachers, course coordinators, they will be interacting with you for the maximum duration of 40 minutes. And some time will be provided for you to contact from or to dealing from one of the lecture and join to the next lecture. There will be mostly 5 lectures per day. Sometimes you will be requested to join for the 6 lectures per day. And then at the frag end of the semester, we will be running the practical program. So all this communication has been given to you by the academic section of my institute. And I am aware that all of you must be having this timetable for the online teaching program. For some of the information which is not available and which I am not delivering here, I am requesting all of you that we are giving you a course book, and that course book is available on the VNIT website, because physically I cannot give it to you this time, which will include timetable, the academic calendar, all the detailed part of that, the detailed syllabus of every courses, what is the depth and width of the courses, the useful phone numbers right from the director to the hostel in charges, the dean hostels, and everybody, the medical officer of my institute. So all those useful mobile numbers and phone numbers are given to you. Then similarly, for this year, we are running the online classes on the two system. One is a WebEx platform, and some of the teachers are doing on the Google Suite. So all of you will be requested to join those particular platforms to get the first-hand information from my teachers. All the course coordinator, they are sending you the link for the respective course curricula, and all of you are requested to join them as per the link which will be provided to you. As coming down to the evaluation mechanism, mostly we are having two semester or two evaluation mechanism during the complete semester, what we call it as a two midterm examination, which will be of around 15 to 20 marks each. And then continuous evaluation of the teachers of around 10 marks, where the teacher is giving assignment, quizzes, seminars, and then end semester examination, which is mostly of around 50 to 60 marks, and followed by this re-examination. And those who are even after the re-examinations are not clearing it, we are providing a very special program called as summer term program, where the students, those who are failed in this type of activities, they will be joining these courses. The classes will be conducted, and at the end, we are running an examination and providing a full opportunity for the student to clear it before they join to the next semester. But this academic year, 2021, we have a slight change into the evaluation mechanism also. We will be running only one midterm examination, because it is all online examination this year. And just like online classes, there will be an online examination for you, which will be of 25 marks. And already I communicated to the time on which we are conducting this. Then major chunk of marks will be on the teacher's assessment. So when my all teachers are interacting with you and are requesting you to submit the assignment, I request you to submit it in due course of time, because 40 marks are allotted to the teacher's assessment. And therefore, these are your marks. If you can do it properly, you will be getting these marks. So before the end semester examination, you are clearing 65 marks out of the 100 marks. And the last examination will be of 35 marks. In all, it will be 100 marks total evaluation for this pandemic period of 2021. The results of each examinations, mostly every teachers are declaring their marks, even all the answer books are shown to the student. We follow 100% transparent systems. You can interact with your teacher. You can even ask the student teacher why the marks are not allotted to me. So valid answer books are shown to the students, number one. Number two, the results of each examinations are mostly declared within 1 week time. And that is the greatest achievement of VNIT, that we are providing all the results in due course. Then end semester grade card and the semester mark sheets, etc., is all available on the VNIT website, www.vnit.ac.in. And I am hereby requesting all the parents, most of the time we are not aware about the progress of our ward, and therefore I am requesting all of you that you can have a look of the grade card from our website, and there is a mechanism which has been specified through that you can know the progress of your son. Apart from all this, we are also looking into some of the very, very important aspect about the evaluation system. Because this is a slightly different method of evaluation, and every institute is having some different mechanism. So let me talk about the last two slides on the grades. We have a 0 to 10 grade system, and basically we call it as a 4 to 10 grade system. And it has been indicated here all the marks which has been allotted to you out of the 100 marks. The grades are given, and the grades will start from AA to DD. and the grade points are also specified. FF is the grade which is given when the candidate is failing. And apart from this, there are number of grades also which has been specified and given in the course book. I am not specifying here on the slide. Then there is one more important point from the student point of view is the earned grade point. And that is actually the product of the credits which has been allotted to the course and the credit grade point awarded to the student. And suppose let us imagine a student has been awarded a BB grade in a 4-credit program. So the total earned grade point will be 4 × 8, that is 32. And like that, you will add everything. And that is together will be given for a semester called as semester grade point average program. And when the 2 semester or 8 semester together are combined, we call it as a cumulative grade point average program, CGPA. Next. I would like to show you one of the mark sheet. And basically for the first semester, we will run a credit program. So you will be having, give me one click. Yeah. So you will be having a credit. So let us imagine that here I have indicated you on the blue color, that is basically indicating that it is a credits for a given course. And then the students were awarded the grade point. Accordingly, he received certain amount of grade point. Multiplication of the credit and the grade point will give you the earned grade point in the last column. And based upon that, suppose let us imagine a student has been awarded 166 grade point now, and the total amount of the credits available are 21. So 166 divided by 21 will give you the SGPA, that is 7.90. Like that for every semester, one more click. Like that for every semester, we will be getting a program, and these particular program when joined together will give you the cumulative grade point program. And that cumulative grade point program has been given at the bottom, where once the first semester is 7.90, the second semester is 7.59. So CGPA will become 7.74. So like that, every student will be evaluated and he will be getting a grade card system from VNIT. One very important point which I would like to elaborate to all of you, attendance is one of the very, very important aspect in getting more better information from all my teachers. So students are expected to attend 100% of classes, but we know there are certain medical issues and therefore a relaxation has been given to all of you, but not more than 25% relaxation will be provided. 75% attendance is compulsory. Without that, you will not be allowed to appear for the end semester examination. This is one of the very, very important thing. And as per the requirement, a course coordinator can take up a decision and will not allow you to appear for the end semester. So please be careful about the attendance. Otherwise, you have no other option but to repeat the subject into the next year once the W grade has been awarded to you. Next. Some of the important points which I would also like to inform to the parents is that student who is having more than 7 backlogs at a time and the students who has earned less than 10 credits in 2 consecutive semesters, and if the student does not complete the degree program in 12 regular semesters, that is 6 years, or 14 regular semesters for BR, that is 7 years, then we are not allowing the studentship to such students. The studentship gets cancelled out and the students will be requested to take its TC back. And we don't expect that this should happen with you. So I'm requesting all the parents and also to all the students to focus on academics properly and see to it that you will be doing wonderfully well. One more important request which I am requesting to all of you, because of maybe any reason, maybe medical or maybe some unexpected reasons, if you are absent for more than 20 days in any curricula, then the information should be given to the institute through the faculty coordinators, to the head of the departments, or through me. Otherwise, the system will automatically generate a registration process cancellation. So I am requesting all of you to be aware about all these important type of activities. Lastly, the most important point that whenever we are appearing for any course, we should be felicitated and awards should be given to all of you. So there are so many awards, but basically I would like to focus to the first year award. So Sir Vishweshwariya Gold Medal is given to the BTech topper from all the branches in the final year during the convocation program. Apart from that, we have so many awards sponsored by various donors and the teachers of the institute. And then we have also institute medal for the toppers of each branch. But for the first year, I am basically giving you that you have a very good competition for the 5 awards which has been already launched for you. Academic Excellence Prize for getting the best performance in the first year, including the first and second semester. Then Professor Vasanta and Srimati Sushila Mukashi Prize for highest marks in the engineering mechanics at the first year BTEC program. Late Sri V. Narasimha Raidu Prize for the highest marks in chemistry at the first year activity. Then Dr. H.G. Gangrekar Award and Dr. A.G. Deshpande Award for highest marks in mathematics at the first semester and the second semester taken together. So these are the 5 awards for all the students, those who can compete properly and try to achieve it. I am expecting a very, very tough competition from all of you. With this, I am sure you will be having a wonderful time in VNIT. A very systematic academic program has been planned for you. Have a good learning at VNIT. All the best for your future endeavor. And I'm sure within the span of 4 years, you will be getting a wonderful brand name of VNIT. And I'm sure all my students will be doing it with the flying colors. With this, best of luck and welcome to the family of VNIT. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor Peshwe. Now I request Professor D.H. Latte, Associate Dean, Hostel Affairs, to brief about the hostel facilities in the VNIT campus.
Good afternoon, respected Director, all deans, or the office bearers of Alumni Association, my dear colleagues, respected parents, and dear students' friends. I am Dilip Viradram Latte, Associate Dean, Hostel Affairs. Here, I am going to introduce you about the hostels, our hostel team, and all the facilities which are given in the hostels. So, presentation. कर सकते हैं इसका रिजल्ट। Next. Okay, so we have various hostels in as our director sir introduced you. VNIT has about 215 acres of campus, and we have about 14 buildings for hostels, which are separate for girls and boys. So there is Warden's Council, then the different facilities in all hostels, or then mess management. Of anti-ragging mechanism to curb the ragging menace. Then there are certain general rules which are formed for the benefit of the students for their future. So we have total, as I told you, so there are 14 buildings, so which are starting from block 1 to 10 extension. And the overall capacity for boys is about 3536, that is 3536. Students can be accommodated in all hostel, that is boys. And there are separate two buildings for girls, so which has have the capacity of about 900, so which can be increasing if it is required. So overall we have total 3387 rooms, where about 4436 students, including girls and boys, can be accommodated. Here, these are some of the buildings which have come up last two years. Hostel block number 2, which is G plus 10 building, which has a capacity of about 520. That building has a multi-activity center, which includes mess and the gymnasium also. This is a girls hostel, which is G plus 11 building. Again, which has come up last two years, which is having a multi-activity food complex. Then this is our team, which includes 18 wardens, including our dean students, Dr. B.S. Umre, or two hostel assistant registrars, who are helping us in the day-to-day administrative activities of the hostel section. The facilities in hostels are recreation room in every hostel. Internet connection is provided. Solar water heaters are provided. Sports facilities are there. Gymnasium in all hostels. Then reading rooms in all hostels. Health insurance is provided for all the hostel inmates. Then 24 hours ambulance service. This is one of the the hall which is provided at the multi-activity center, which is situated at the nearby hostel, block number 2. And the gymnasium, which is at multi-activity center, a boys hostel. So which is coming up because of this pandemic situation, we could not set it up due to this situation. But finishing this, or after the subsidence of this, so it will be set up. In girls hostel, there is a separate gymnasium for girls, so which is equipped with all the equipment which are required for the exercise. So as everybody knows, this mental and physical strengths are both mutually important. So therefore, we are providing these facilities. And at the same time, we have the one gymnasium at the central place, which is near the auditorium in the VNIT campus. So there are total 3 gymnasiums in the whole campus for hostels and also for the day scholars. As far as the mess management is concerned, the messes are running on the contract basis. So which has the following capacity. One old mega mess is there because this was set up in about 2006, also which has a capacity of about 1,000 to 1,500 students. Mega mess new, which has capacity of, which we saw, that is multi-activity center, which has capacity of 1,500 students. PG hostel, we have a separate PG hostel, so in which we are accommodating PhD and M.Tech students, which has the dining capacity of about 500 to 700 students. There is separate mess for girls hostel, which is having capacity of 1,000 to 1,500, and another mess is there, which has capacity of 500 students. All messes are operated on contract basis, as I told you. Then as per the UGC Act, Anti-Ragging Act, as everybody knows, this anti-ragging mechanism should be there. And let me tell you, we do not have any, not a single incidence of ragging in VNIT campus till now. There is, of course, at the institute level, there is an anti-ragging committee. We have the anti-ragging squad. So this is specially prepared for the hostels. So these people, they have visit every day to the hostels to curb the meanness of this ragging. So these are certain important rules, I can say. Use of motor. So dear parents, let me tell you, use of motor vehicles by hostel inmates is strictly not permitted. That is prohibited. The entire MCFR, this is for first year, first and second semester. As these, we are providing this. That is, in time for the girls and boys is 8 p.m. Consumption of alcohol, tobacco, gutkha, smoking, substance abuse, etc. are strictly prohibited and they are not tolerated in our campus. All other rules are displayed on the institute website that anybody can see that. I will also request you, please do not involve yourself in all these activities. Yes, so dear students, let me congratulate you first for getting or acquiring admission in one of the Institute of National Importance, and welcome at the same time. There are some suggestions which are, you can say, the requests for the students. So keep your room clean, maintain discipline, don't involve yourself in any act of indiscipline. Utilize health services. We have very good health services in VNIT campus. In case of any serious health issues or past history, inform to doctors. Be regular in class and studies. Communicate with wardens, parents, mentors, teachers regarding studies or any problem. Keep your contact details updated and reachable. Dear parents, please visit institute at least once in a semester to meet your ward. Wardens, teachers, HODs, etc. Keep your mobile numbers updated. So these are the all requests from my side. And I hope we meet soon after subsidence of this pandemic situation. Thank you, one and all, for hearing patiently. Thank you. And with this, I wish you all the best and safe stay in the VNIT campus. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor Lattai. Now I request Professor B.S. Umre, Dean Student Welfare, to kindly brief about the student activities in VNIT campus. Thank you, Dhavale sir. Honorable Chairman and Director, Professor Padole sir, Registrar, all deans, all associate deans, head of the departments, medical officer, our strong members of strong alumni association, student mentor program in charge, Professor Keskar, dear students and parents. I am Dean Student Welfare. Welcome you all to the VNIT family. For the safety of the first year students, we have some committees which are taking care of ragging and also look after some other activities. As said by Associate Dean Professor Lattai sir, there are some rules and regulations for the institute and for hostels for maintaining the discipline. You have to follow the rules. If you break the rule and if you are found guilty, then there is heavy fine. Till date we have fined ₹50,000. So take care of rules and regulations. We have good sports center complex. The institute provide a high level of platform. There is all India inter-NIT tournaments to exhibit talent among the students for all other NITs in India. Last year, total 157 students participated in total 12 sports in all India inter-NIT tournaments organized by different NITs in India. You can take part in cricket, table tennis, badminton, powerlifting, bodybuilding, swimming, and other activities. Dr. Ratnesh Kumar is the in charge of, or Dr. Ratnesh Kumar is the associate dean for students and sport activities. Now everybody wants job. We have training and placement section. From third year and final year, depending on your grades, you can appear for interview. Last year, eligible students were 521, job offered 449. So therefore, as explained by the director, 86% students have offered the job. Total number of companies visited 130 for all departments. Maximum salary was given 38.21 lakh and average salary was 8.55 lakh. Some of the companies were Applied Dynamics India Private Limited, DE Shaw Group, Goldman Sachs Services Private Limited, Tata Steel, Bajaj Auto, Persistent System, Reliance, L&T, and so many others. Associate Dean for the Training and Placement is Dr. Raleigh Gaukar. Other than this, we have so many club activities. Axis is technical activity and RO is cultural activity. Then other than this, there are ESL, consortium, dance, halla bol, singing, photography, and so on. As per your interest, you take part in any one or two. To parents, I want to tell, after physical reporting of the wards to the institute, you come and visit hostels, rooms of the hostel, rooms of your ward, see the progress. Visit once in a semester and meet the teachers. Dear students, up to 4 years when you are in VNIT, your religion is student. And the karma of your religion is to study, study, and study. आखिर में दो लाइन पेश करना चाहता हूं. अगर रास्ता खूबसूरत है तो पता कीजिए किस मंजिल तक जाता है. अगर रास्ता खूबसूरत है तो पता कीजिए किस मंजिल तक जाता है. लेकिन अगर मंजिल खूबसूरत है, आपकी मंजिल खूबसूरत है बिकॉज यू हैव टेकन द एडमिशन इन VNIT फॉर BTech एंड BArch. तो लेकिन अगर मंजिल खूबसूरत है तो रास्ते की परवाह मत कीजिएगा. वहां बहुत सारे पत्थर आएंगे, कठिनाई आएंगे, डिफिकल्टीज आएंगे, उसकी परवाह न करते हुए बस चलते जाइए और खूबसूरत मंजिल पाइए. उसके लिए आपको क्या करना पड़ेगा? उसके लिए आपको पढ़ाई करना पड़ेगा. बस पढ़ाई करते रहिए. ओके, थैंक यू.
Thank you very much, Professor Umre. Now I request Dr. Pankaj Dhue, Medical Officer, VNIT Health Center, to brief about the medical facilities in the VNIT campus.
Thank you, Dawale sir. Respected director sir, respected registrar sir, all the deans, members of the alumni association, all faculty members, parents, and my newly admitted friends. First of all, I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate you all for securing a position in such a renowned institute. VNIT has a well-established health unit, Wellness Health Center, and being a senior medical officer, I'm here to represent our team of health center. As we all know that healthy mind and healthy body are interrelated, so secure your excellence in your academic career, you should be healthy. That's why your mind will be healthy. So we will help you here to be in a state of physical, mental, social, and spiritual well-being, which is also known as health or complete health, to provide such a holistic health to the engineering students, faculty, the precious resources of the country. We consider it as an opportunity as well as challenge. And to achieve this goal, we are running here multi-specialty OPD services. We are running the OPD services in two sessions, that is morning and evening. In the morning, 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. and in the evening, 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. on all working days, we are having emergency services, night duty doctor, which is present from 10 p.m. to 6 a.m. from Monday to Friday, and we are having 24/7 ambulance assistance. So this is our health center premises. And as mentioned earlier, we are also having a well-equipped dental center, then a physiotherapy center, and an eye clinic also. So to provide you services, we have a team of qualified professionals and well-trained paramedical staff, which include general physician, gynecologist, pediatrician, eye specialist, dentist, psychiatrist, homeopathic physician, physiotherapist, counselor, and of course the backbone, the paramedical staff. We serve nearly about 5,000 students, two-thirds of which are on the campus, and nearly 500 families. We basically run a youth-friendly health program which rests on four pillars, the first being the screening program. Whenever you visit the health center for the first time, then we will maintain your health diary and your general medical examination will be done, and which will help you to identify, help us to identify high-risk students, and we'll provide counseling to them also. The second pillar is the care and the illness, for which I mentioned earlier, we provide a multi-specialty OPD facilities, and we have on-campus medical officers, emergency care facilities, daycare services, free pharmacy, 24/7 ambulance service also. Then third pillar being the fitness. To achieve this goal, we work in an integrated approach with the various sections, like our physiotherapy section, with sports section, hostel section, mess committee, and we also promote yoga and meditation. All these are helpful to prevent the primary prevention of the lifestyle related disorders. And the fourth and important pillar is the health education. With all these methods, we will try to impinge healthy behavior amongst you, which will help you. So being a self-responsible, being self-disciplined, and confidence in you. So through these all these pillars or all these activities, we will try to achieve the targets, which are health for education for all, implementation of national health programs, detection and treatment of anemia in girls, various disorders, vaccination against various diseases, motivation for sports and exercise, balanced diet, and prevention of roadside accidents and substance abuse. The facilities mentioned earlier was given at our campus only, but apart from these facilities, we have some extended health benefits given to the students in the form of cashless hospitalization. In case of emergency, institute would have empanelment with the leading tertiary care hospitals in the city, which will provide you up to 50,000 cashless hospitalization in case of emergency, which may be extended up to 1 lakh in special cases with the approval of the authorities. So I will like to mention the beneficiaries of this scheme. In the previous years, in the 2017-18, around 148 students being benefited. In the 18-19, around 154 students.
and 1920, around 132 students have taken the benefit of this cashless hospitalization facility. So in return, we will expect some responsible behavior from your end just to keep yourself healthy. So few expectations from us. First and foremost is avoid street food. All around the premises of the variety, there are multiple food stalls. So my sincere request, avoid street food. Then the personal hygiene. So all of you know that the what is personal hygiene, but after taking admission and especially when you are in the hostel, you are reluctant to follow the personal hygiene rules, which will leading to the various skin disorders. So the personal hygiene should be followed. Then, as we know, the stitch in time saves the nine. So my request is that report early for any health-related disease, any health-related issues. Don't wait for the emergency or the situation to worsen. And the foremost is the healthy social relations. So maintain the healthy social relations with your seniors, your colleagues, parents, and teachers to stay in a state of social and mental health. So, and the most important thing for which we are conducting this virtual orientation program is the COVID-19. So I assure that at the institute level, we are following all the COVID-related norms, regular indoor and outdoor spraying and fogging activities being carried out to curtail the spread of virus. Facilities for hand sanitization, washing are being made available at all entry points. Social distancing and use of masks is mandatory in the campus, and hope all of you are also following the COVID norms and keeping yourself and your family members safe. So we are committed to provide you safe, secure, healthy, and of course, a beautiful campus life. Hope to see you soon. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Dhule. Now I request Mr. Uday Kamath, a well-known industrialist and the chairman of VNIT's Alumni Association, to brief about the Alumni Association and its collaboration with VNIT.
Good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon, Dr. Padave, director of the institute and a fellow alumni, I would say. We are privileged to have you, one of our leading members, founder members, deans of the institute, students, and parents. Welcome to VNIT. And I would also welcome you to the city of Nagpur, which is having a rich heritage of over 300 years, also known as a Orange City, as you might be knowing. Recently, it has also acquired a title of being a tiger capital with about 7 sanctuaries nearby. So I'm going to tell you a little bit more outside the campus as well. You have heard enough from the campus side. Nagpur also hosts a 0 mile, where from all the parts of the country are well connected by rail, road, and air. So your parents or you can reach to the campus, to the city, anytime as convenient. It's also a second capital of Maharashtra, one of the most progressive states, and it's a very calm and quiet city to pursue your studies and future. Modern amenities, including a metro rail network, are at your footsteps. So welcome to Nagpur. Particularly for the parents, we would like to tell that in 2010, VNIT completed 50 years of its existence, and they celebrated a golden jubilee in 2010 with more than 1,200 alumni attending that glittering function. The grand success of that generated huge nostalgia, collective resolve to give back to the alma mater in a sustainable manner. This prompted the core organizing group of alumni to incorporate VNIT Nagpur Alumni Association as a not-for-profit company in February 2012. Next. It's primarily the Association of Alumni, which is ex-students of VNIT and erstwhile VRC, As I said, it's a not-for-profit organization. It has received all the necessary certificates from Government of India, Income Tax Act, as a charitable entity. And it's totally funded by alumni donors, as we would see in the upcoming slides. The alumni community, as of today, with 60 years behind it, stands with as a large gathering of 24,000 graduates spread far and wide geographically, with first batch graduating way back in 1963. I, for myself, was in your shoes in August 1979, 41 years ago, when it was an exciting time. At the same time, we were a little nervous to enter the campus, as large as, maybe that time it was 300 acres campus. The facilities today are modern, and I'm sure you're going to enjoy that. Every year, 1,000 students are now taking admissions and completing their course. The mission of VNIT Nagpur Alumni Association is to act as an extended arm of VNIT management. Idea is to build bonds between alumni, students, and the institute to keep alumni informed, create a network, to remain engaged with their alma mater, and shape the students' future along with it. We carry out mentoring activities, industry events, infrastructural developments, campus amenities, awards, and financial assistance to needy students, in all with collaboration with the VNIT management. Idea is to assist VNIT to produce engineers and architects of highest caliber while creating a vibrant professional culture capable of addressing the technological needs of the society today. This is the current board of directors. We have 11 members. Two of them are ladies. One is an architect. And as you see, the members include two nominee directors, Dr. Peshwe, who spoke to you before me, Dr. Jatin Bhatt. These are the two nominees appointed by the director of VNIT. So there is a full-scale collaboration and a bridge between the two. The day-to-day affairs of the association are being managed by a team of the chairman, that's myself, for the term. Executive director, Mr. Joginder Singh, who is a full-time director of the association and is always available in the office for your students or your wards. And Director Treasurer, Mr. Kamlesh Laddad, is one of our youngest directors. Now, who are our stakeholders as we identify? First is the Institute. And how do we collaborate? We participate in infrastructure development, like the statue portion, which Professor mentioned, promenade beautification, dining hall, football ground, tennis court. These are the additions which we did in last about 6 to 7 months, and we intend to continue that activity. These facilities would only go to upgrade the campus. Campus facilities would also include some laboratory setups, modernization of certain laboratories, EV buses to move around in the campus for the parents as well as for the students. Chandramas student canteen was upgraded. And we are also shortly coming up with a laundrette facility, sir. For the hostelers in particular, in girls and boys hostel, we would like to set up that laptop bank for the needy students who could be challenged for the online education part. So you need to access all these activities online, and we would be there to help you. Academic and research contributions. VNIT Alumni Association is running an entrepreneurship course for the second year onward students for last 4 years. We'll be getting into the fifth year now. It's being run in collaboration with the faculty from the college, and the course syllabus is at par with what you are being taught in the IITs and the Silicon Valley. We also arrange guest lectures from distinguished alumni with a lot of experience under their belt. We would love to support VNIT as we have been doing so far in the NIRF ranking improvement by way of perception scores and facilities. Upcoming ideas would be also welcome in terms of undergraduate and postgraduate projects, which our industry alumni connect would be able to bring to the campus. The second most important stakeholder would be the alumni, where we cater to those people who have completed 25 years, that is Silver Jubilee, 50 years, that is a Golden Jubilee. We also conduct an alumni reunion every year. Distinguished Alumni Awards is a function, again, done in collaboration with the Institute. We have chapters worldwide. We have chapters within India, and the network is far and far flung to all, I would say, major cities of India as well as in major countries. The alumni communicate through a newsletter called Edge. This is a bi-monthly edition. And we also work to make the life easier for our alumni, particularly overseas, by supplying transcript on demand for them, which is required for some admissions to universities, or it could be for the jobs. Support in distress is always available to the alumni in need. The next and most important is the students, and the parents would be happy to note that we walk along with your students, along with your wards. First is the home away from home, which we conduct normally for the first years so that they don't feel homesick. This is particularly for Diwali occasion where the director, the staff, faculty, and even alumni participate in the get-togethers. Financial assistance to needy students, mentorship to the students, entrepreneurship course I mentioned. As you move to the second year and third year, internship assistance is also provided to the industries where alumni have a connection. We also help bring additional companies. We have been mentioned about 130 companies come to the campus regularly. We would be adding 5, 10, whatever we can through our connect so that the placement becomes better and better. We also support the students through Access and Consortium, their events by way of sponsorships or bringing the alumni to the campus for those events. Last but not least, when you graduate after 4 years, we would definitely conduct a graduation lunch, farewell lunch for you. Of course, social responsibility, because we all survive in a large world and a connected society. So we cannot forget our social responsibility. So we work with NGOs like Goonj and Prayas through initiatives from Dr. Peshwe. It's a VNIT students initiative we support. We also did a COVID-19 fundraiser. We would see the details of it a little later. As we come to see the institute related activities, I mentioned about the machine learning lab was set up by one batch of 1993. CSE students. The 1983 and 84 batches provided 14-seater EVs for campus movement of students and parents. Diamond Jubilee is something which we are all proud of and excited about. VNIT has been completing 60 glorious years of imparting quality education in 2020. This has seen a transformation from VRC, that is Regional College, where we all studied, to VNIT now. On this auspicious occasion, chairman, director, faculty, staff and students and alumni put together would be celebrating it with a gusto throughout the year with various programs. We have seen these pictures before, so I would not repeat that. This is a batch of 1982 led by Dr. Padoe himself. He is 1 year senior to me. So this is what he did as flagship project for alumni as well for the college. Second one is, this is 83 and 84 batch, which did along with Promenade to make it beautiful, as you can see on the day and night pictures. 85 is something which was close to all hostelers' heart, Chandrama Canteen, which was upgraded, refurbished. And 1992 batch definitely came forward and created a new football ground for the students to play. These are the pictures of 19 January, as we saw earlier, and these are the kind of nostalgia you could see when more than 600 alumni attended the inaugural function on the 19th January 2020, when all the first phase projects were inaugurated. And this is how the batch-wise collection and the competition. We engineers and we architects are always competitive by nature. So all the batches which created and collected about 50 lakhs and above, those were felicitated. 1981, 82, 84, and 83 batch was the first one to reach 1 crore. So there is a competition, healthy competition to compete for corpus addition and giving back to the alma mater. Next. Yeah, this is where, if you can see, this is the global reach or footprint of VNIT. This is work in process. Data is being updated, but as you could see, from Australia to America to Brazil, Middle East, Africa, and of course, India. Alumni are everywhere. These are the chapters which you could see zone-wise in Kolkata, Chhattisgarh. West is Mumbai, Pune, Gujarat, Vidarbha, of course. North we have in Delhi, South, Bangalore, Hyderabad, Chennai. Overseas we have in Dubai and America. Upcoming are Singapore, Australia, and even in UK. We also celebrate the events like Golden Jubilee, where 1969 batch came last year. Over 100 alumni participated. Their energy was infectious. Everybody was close to 75, but they all behaved like a 20-year-old on the campus. So something which was worth praising. Then we had a Silver Jubilee batch, which was 1994. So every year we have these celebrations on our calendar, particularly in the month of December. We also, as I said, we support through transcripts on demand. We have chapter meets where the director for our, say, office bearers travel and meet the alumni at various cities. Recently, we had carried a roadshow in Dubai as well as in Bangalore for the Diamond Jubilee. The newsletter I mentioned, Edge, and we have a full-fledged website to cater to alumni. That is vnitalumni.com, where you can find out which city, which country you would be able to find a VNITian who would be warmly welcoming you for any need of yours. Distinguished Alumni Award, this is the function held last year. Producer has already mentioned. You can see these pictures and the details of profiles of all these role models for you on our website as well as Institute's website. Professor Suresh Deshpande, then we have people who have contributed to services. We have Mr. Telang, who was heading Tata Motors. We have Dr. Ramesh Jain and many more. We couldn't list everybody here. Dr. Dinesh Keskar, Rashmita Urdhvareshe got a Sri Shakti Award at the hands of President this year, Mr. Unnikrishnan. Let me say, the success of any school can be measured by the contributions the alumni make to the national life. This is what John Kennedy said once. And I think our list of distinguished alumni only goes to justify that. Next. Now, coming to the student-related activities. As we have mentioned, from first year home away from home till graduation lunch, we hold your hands from first year to fourth year, including internships, including placement, including any counseling, physical, personal, professional, any type of counseling. Our doors are always open to you. Social activities, we mentioned about the COVID-19 work. At a simple call from our then chairman, Sri Shashikant Chaudhary, in 6 weeks, we collected about 40 lakhs, 400 alumni contributed. We could provide monthly ration kits to 2,600 families. 12,000 ready meal packets were served to slum dwellers, daily wagers. We supported the NMC and Nagpur Collectorate. We also helped the doctors who were serving the society at that time in terms of PPE kits, N95 masks to government and private hospitals. These are some of the pictures of that distribution. Then we also are engaged in regular activities with Goonj founder and Magsaysay awardee, Mr. Anshu Gupta. And Daan Utsav is carried out almost every year. Now, how does VNITA support these activities? Are we funded by government or are we funded by anybody else? No. The answer is the alumni themselves, they are helping themselves. The activities are entirely funded by member alumni through life memberships, which is 5,000 rupees, a one-time payment. Sponsorships, which is, as you can see from the list, starting from below, 1 lakh is the minimum. We have 130 silver sponsors, 27 gold sponsors, each contributing 3 lakhs and more, 22 platinum sponsors with 5 lakhs and more, and 9 millionaire clubs with 10 lakhs and more. Today, we stand with 1750 plus life members, 200 sponsors, and the gross contribution by alumni so far in a brief span of 8 years is about 6.4 crores. Our idea is to double this in the next 3 years to come. And how do we acknowledge this, all these donors? Through a wall of honor, which is firmly placed on an office, which is provided kindly by the Institute. And so whoever comes up with a contribution for the alma mater, we definitely deeply honor that. We deeply recognize that and we appreciate that. Back. Now, coming to another part, we have learned about the academics of it, but these 4 years, friends, are the best 4 years of your life. This I can tell you from my experience, and all the faculty members would endorse that. You're today 17, 18, and you would be graduating at 22, maybe 23. These 4 years are something which you would cherish forever in your life. The friendships you make, the bonds you build would be lifetime bonds. And otherwise, why would it bring a person like me after 40 years to the campus again and again? So you would realize this once you pass out. Till such time, make full use of this time. build your personality, have a 360 degree view, academics, sports, cultural, professional. This is the best period for you. This is much I can definitely say from my own experience. We would like to assure the parents that this is a home away from home. The campus is there. We have more than 700 alumni based in Nagpur. Campus is there, faculty members are there, college management is there, and we are there to support you. So don't worry about your what. And at the end, I would like to quote from what Mr. Narayan Murthy, founder of Infosys, said, that nobody is bothered about an institution more than its alumni, simply because the brand VNIT or brand of the institute helps us lifetime. It helps you today, it helps us tomorrow, it helps us day after tomorrow. So throughout our professional life, we would like to see that brand VNIT grows and grows and further it grows. Simply because you are a student for 4 years, but you are an alumni for rest of your life. Mind my words, you are going to acquire a second surname at the end of 4 years. You would be also called as a VNITian apart from your family name. Thank you and good luck to you.
Thank you very much, Udayji Kamath sir. Now I request Professor R.B. Keskar, in charge student mentor program, to brief about the program.
So perhaps in a long program, this is the last presentation. But at the same time, this could be the presentation where we could tell you whom you can immediately contact in case of any need. So for that, VNIT has come up with a program which is called a Students Mentor Program. We started in 2012. And we'll be basically getting a brief about what this program does and how you would get connected. Rather, you are already connected. We are aware of it because student mentors have contacted you during the reporting process and many of the issues that you have raised through them. So perhaps this is an attempt to go through this, the whole concept and what we have been doing in a little bit more structured manner. So mainly parents as well as the students both are aware of it. So at this time, basically, you must be having the mixed feelings. Good that you have got an NIT, perhaps branch of your choice, sometimes not. And definitely there is an anxiety about further studies over here. The typical concerns in normal times that we would have is about new environment, adjusting with system, studies, health, friends, guidance, local guardian. Incidentally, right now, those concerns are not there for you because you are at your homes. But definitely once this pandemic subsides and you come down at the campus, these concerns would again start coming in. Rather, they would definitely be there. Perhaps at this time, the concern that you have is how the online learning is going to happen and how your exams and evaluations are going to happen. And there are definitely long-term concerns, the further studies, jobs, career. Perhaps to some extent, it was addressed by Uday Kamath sir in the previous slide, where they said that alumni will be supporting you through this in the next 4 years. But at the same time, these concerns definitely exist and you want some peer help as well. So this program essentially is trying to help you out. So this SMP, which is the Student Mentor Program, as we know it as SMP, is a solution to immediate concerns definitely, and little bit on the longer side as well. So firstly, it is designed to provide a communication channel for the student with the system, because system works in a particular way. And as a new student, you are not aware that whom to contact for this particular point, problem. Many times you depend on your seniors who may or may not help you depending on their time availability or a lot of other reasons. So in 2012, the Institute thought that there should be a structured way in which we can provide this help to you from students' side themselves, and who better mentors that you can have than your seniors. So typically, who is a student mentor? Student mentor is a third year student from the same branch. That is important. So the student mentor knows about that particular branch and what comes next, basically. a student mentor is selected through an elaborate selection and interview process. I can tell you that it goes on for at least for a month. This time we conducted it completely online. Normally we receive 300 plus applications every year. To put the things in context, remember that our student strength is close to 900, so which means that one in every three students every year wants to become a student mentor. And that is from the feeling of giving it back. I mean, whatever they have been benefited with because of the student mentor in their first year, they want to give it back to the next batches. And out of these 300 applications, we select around 60 to 65. So 1:5 is the selection ratio typically. In the selection process is not basically is very well structured. The faculty of the same department that we call is faculty coordinators, then senior student mentors from the fourth year as well as third year. Our health center counselors, they are closely involved in the selection process. When I say closely involved, they're actually part of the interview process. And department-wise student mentor list is actually been given to you in the first year brochure that you have received. And a specific allocation to every student mentor will happen soon as the list is getting finalized now. And we'll be doing it in such a way that many of the students from the same section get allotted to the same mentor so that the mentor is aware of the specific issues being faced. So every student mentor has 15 mentees, freshmen. And when I say you'll be introduced to them today, of course, you have been introduced on WhatsApp and other mediums. So as you are aware that we have created these WhatsApp groups for every department. But today, perhaps you will see them in the second half when they interact with you on the WebEx platform. There are department meetings set up, so where they will introduce themselves. You have been also assigned a faculty mentor who is a faculty for first year. Typically, the teacher who teaches you for that particular section. And the name of your faculty mentor is given to you in your first year academic brochure. So there are four batches which are mentioned in your, I mean, one of the four batches mentioned in your admission letter. Let's say you are from section S, S1, S2, S3, S4. So let's say S1 and S2 would have one faculty mentor, S2, S3 and S4 would have another faculty mentor. So you could quickly see your brochure and know the contact details of your faculty mentor who can help you out in connecting with other teachers of the same section, because the faculty mentor is connected with all other teachers of the same section. So this is the two-way structure of student mentor program. On the left side, you see that it is through the student side that we have 15 freshmen monitored by or rather mentored by one student mentor. So typically we have, let's say, 120 students in most of the batches right now, branches right now. So we have 8 mentors. And then in some branches like, let's say, architecture or mining, the number of students are less, so less number of mentors, but we maintain the ratio of 1:15. And then there is a faculty coordinator from that particular engineering branch. Remember that your mentor is also from the same engineering branch that you have got. And faculty coordinator is also from the same engineering branch. So this is a department-wise structure that we have created. And this will remain for basically next 2 years till your mentor is in the institute, who is in third year right now. So for first and second year, basically mentor would provide you the help. Most of the help, of course, is required in the first year. And there is a parallel structure, which is specific only to the first year, where around 40 to 50 freshmen are allotted to one faculty mentor, as I said, two batches. And typically the teacher is from basic sciences and applied mechanics who teach specifically to the first year students. Student mentor will assist new students. That's what the primary goal of student mentor program is in getting you integrated with the system. Parents shall certainly interact and meet with student mentor. And when I say that, basically this was always the case when you come down on the campus to let your ward admitted into the institute and stay here. But even now it is going to happen once you come down on the campus after this pandemic subsides. You should definitely collect student mentors' contact details, and we'll be generally they have visiting cards. This time we'll be printing the e-card basically, and then we'll giving them the actual paper cards. Once they are also at their homes, they will also come down. So right now you can collect their details, their mobile numbers and other things, and perhaps e-cards also in next 2-3 days. The parents should definitely have the mobile numbers with SMs, the numbers of SMs, as well as they should share their own numbers with student mentors. Student mentors will be asking these numbers to parents. And parents can share their concerns and issues with SMs. Normally, this is required because the student is here and parents are at their homes, and then they have some concerns about their ward, basically. So this applies at that time more, I would say. And in general, the student mentor will enhance your as well as students' comfort level. That's the whole goal. Next slide, please. So health center is closely associated with student mentor program. And we have medical officer as well as two counselors right now to help student mentor and addressing different issues. And believe me that every year we do handle some issues that first year students face along with the help of counselors as well as the parents. We also involve parents. So don't get, alarmed if the counselors would call you. Basically, it is for basically to understand something or make sure that some issues are getting resolved. Generally, SMs can come to the hostel if needed, to first year hostel. Normally, the senior students are not allowed in first year hostels, but we would allow student mentors with their ID cards basically to come in over there. In this case, in the online situation, of course, the student mentor will be talking with the mentees in online mode. And once the student comes onto the campus for any medical emergency, of course, they have to call the health center. But if they are a little bit doubtful, perhaps basically they can also inform student mentor, who can inform the relevant people basically. And keep important phone numbers with you. Typically, the visiting card of student mentor will have those numbers at the back of the card. Not only that, the student mentor, the student SMP brochure that has been shared with you, also have all these numbers. All the numbers of the important numbers of VNIT authorities are mentioned, and different departments are mentioned over there. Next slide, please. So the what student mentor program, in briefly, student mentors will tell you about this, and we'll very briefly go over. I will not discuss it. This is what student mentors will discuss with you in the second half today. Of course, Dean sir has talked to you about many of these things, and if you have some doubts immediately arising, perhaps you can discuss with student mentors. So you would learn about academic calendar, dates of exams, pattern of evaluation in the online mode. Perhaps it is you will be more interested to know that. Explanation about credits and grades, Peshwa sir has already done, but perhaps you may want to have second queries on that. Re-exams, academic rules about co-curricular and extracurricular activities and different clubs, different events, etc. SM will also tell you the strength of your branch. Believe me that again, that some of the branches you may think that you should have got this one, but you got that one. But then you would realize that your student mentors know much more about the specific branch, and perhaps you would be happy to be in the branch that you have got. Different awards, internships, again, Dean Academic Sir has mentioned, but again, more details if you require, you can ask student mentors. Professional bodies in your field, student membership of societies, information of co-curricular, extracurricular, whom to contact in a given situation. So all these things basically a student mentor helps out. And imagine that you are at your home, but once you come down on the campus, this becomes much more important. So in short, student mentor is a senior friend, buddy, and guide who can understand you. Meetings, generally we consider this as a sacrosanct. So basically every student mentor meet the student mentees once in a week initially when they come down on the campus, because that is the time students feel homesick. And attendance is taken in this meeting. Not that it is kind of compulsory, but someone does not attend meetings throughout, basically, again and again, this becomes an alarm for us why the student is not attending. There's a fun in these meetings generally going on and some important things getting discussed. This is mandatory for mentees to attend meetings. One has to be in regular touch with student mentors. Any case of problem, of course, you talk freely with student mentor. And please understand that student mentors have undergone exactly same situations. I should not have said 5 years back, it is just only actually 2 years back, and they can exactly know what you feel. Many of the faculty here are also alumni of the same institute, there is alumni association, but we have done our graduation many decades back, basically. So student mentors would quickly understand the specific problems. Although this year is a bit different, we understand, so meetings will happen online, at least initially. Next slide, please. Yeah, so some of the actions that we have taken in this specific corona situation from our end, we formed department-wise WhatsApp groups on 24th November, one day before the reporting. And as the reporting started during 25th November to 1st December, every day as the reporting data was coming into us, we kept on adding students department-wise into those WhatsApp groups. And then many of the doubts were asked on those forums, which we communicated with the DR academic and DR exams, AR exams, and they resolved most of the doubts, basically. Still, there might be some it actually also helped us to come up with some policies as well regarding, let's say, email changes and phone number changes are becoming very important today. They may not have become when you personally come down, but they are becoming important right now. So there is a process which has been now laid down, and you might have got the notice regarding that couple of days back. And in general, this has helped students and parents to connect with the system through SMS right away when the reporting was going on. So there is a brochure about student mentor program. It is available on website, exactly on the same page where you saw all the reporting data. So there you would see a brochure over there, and student mentors will also be sharing one copy. They might have already done so, but they would share one latest copy with you. So there are initiatives to help weak students also, which we take from our end. Last many years, we have been taking this English improving and remedial classes because we realize that many of the students are coming from vernacular background and they require this specific help. They are very intelligent, but they are a little bit weak on the language side. And incidentally, all the teaching actually happens in English, basically, at all the engineering institutes. So to make these students come up easily, we conduct these English improving classes typically in third week of August normally, which is like 1 month after the classes start. This time we are planning to do it in January. Of course, they will happen in online mode now. They're conducted generally in the evening for 1 hour. And we normally ask students who are interested in attending this. So many students who are coming from humble backgrounds or from vernacular backgrounds, they would take help of these classes. There will be special meetings by faculty mentors after sessional exams, before the exams, after the exams, counseling and all other sessions would happen every year. Next slide, please. And there was one extra thing that we started last year, which actually incidentally helped us. It was like serendipity, I would say, but unknowingly we did that. So we did something called student excellence learning program in the first week of March, rather, where a lot of activities and games were played basically within first year students. Initially, they were reluctant because it was already 7 or 8 months in the institute, but we said that, okay, this is going to be a little bit different. And a lot of stress relieving techniques were taught, breathing techniques, yogasanas, pranayams, and all these techniques were taught. This was done as through TechWIP 3 as a norm of NPIU. And what happened was, after lockdown started, we got a lot of people coming back to us, a lot of students coming back to us and saying that this program has helped them a lot to cope up with the lockdown in the initial periods, initial 2-3 months, and they were continuing these activities. So definitely we'll like to do this again in the coming year also, because as we are going through many different kind of stresses at this point in time. Finally, we'll come to, next slide, please. Finally, come to some one very unique activity we have been doing in student mentor program for last 2 years. Typically, we do this in the second week of August, and this is mainly for DJEI is the student, and DJEification is what we call. And why it is required is, basically, we realize that when students come down, they are still in their 11th, 12th hang, their JE numbers they remember and JEIRs they remember, and they are still into that mode. We want you to get free of that. And we want you to make friends with each other. So we want you to throw away your stress, anxiety, negativity, explore new things, activities which you may not have done any time. We want some icebreakers to be there. We want you to make friends early and develop some positive attitude. So let me do one thing. 2 years back, whatever we did, there is a long video, but I will just show you a glimpse of 2 minutes. You will also see campus in a different mode now. The classrooms, live classrooms, you will see. And we'll just run video, just give a half a minute. We'll start the video and then we'll come back to the slides.
Engineering education, for that matter, any education should not be just a transmission of the information, but it should be a transmission of values, ethics, good professional practices along with the information. Keeping this in view, MHRD and AICT has suggested to organize orientation programs for first-year students. In this regard, VNIT has recently organized 1 week orientation program for the first-year students during 6th to 11th August 2018. During this program, various events like short film making, then making best out of best, and similar such events were organized. The main purpose of this event to make the students aware of the institute, and this will also result into making them a good student, understanding each other, working in a team, and similar such characteristics will be developed in the student, and that will make the student a multifaceted personality.
So during the beginning of the semester, we got the information that we have to accommodate induction activities for the first year of students. Initially, we thought it would consume more time in the semester, but then we could accommodate the induction activities within the existing academic schedule with minimum disturbances.
As a dean, student welfare, I appreciate the work done by student mentor committee. The induction program was for 5 days. It was good program that increases the strength of our first year students, which helps them to mix up with the senior students and how to talk with the senior students. That was a very good program done by student mentor program.
The first thought that came to my mind was how lucky are the first years that they are able to experience all these workshops and activities other than academics just in the first week of college. They taught about editing softwares, basic skills like direction, lighting, sounds, everything was covered. All the basics were covered really well and in a very systematic manner. Even it was a very interactive session.
That they had to prepare something out of random stuffs that were given to them. So that I felt was the best part of Makers in Action, because it enabled them to activate the creative side of their brain, and at the same time they were able to bond with their batchmates, and I could see people with happy faces at the end of the session.
Yeah, so I could see happy faces. That is the note that we want to make basically, and remember that these are the students just after 10 days coming to the campus. You could see the bonhomie over there, the energy over there, and camaraderie over there along with each other. And that we could achieve through this program in first 2 weeks itself, thus removing a lot of concerns that parents would have or the students would have about being being held up over here, in the sense that homesick and things like that. So I think this has helped us. So this I have mentioned, and then last year what activities we did, I think I will just we need not go through all of those. There were creative activities, short filmmaking, design innovation, voiceover anchoring, theater dramatics on the creative side, origami itself. Then there were Know Your Campus, faculty, clubs, counselors, student mentors, etc. We did expert lectures on time management, active learning, professional ethics, managing success failure, managing mood, sleep, eating, that we did, stress relief, breathing, meditation I talked about. And finally, women's issues and Gandhian thoughts. These were the two additional aspects we added last time. Last year being 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, as well as women's issues are becoming very important. So this we did last year. So of course, the question would be, so these are some of the snapshots. Of course, it's not required, but you could see some of the creations being done over here. And yeah, and there are some other things which could see a lot of happiness spread around. And this year you might be concerned at how we would be doing this year now. So we'll be splitting it into two parts. We are in a very different situation. The exams of your student mentors are starting. Please remember that they are starting from 8th of December up to 15th of December. They are end sem exams. So they may not be as available to you that they would be normally like to. And you have to please understand that. Of course, you can send them messages and all those things. And we require their help in the induction program. So what we'll do is, in the last week of December, we'll do some of the activities which we can do online. Of course, there is no point in doing icebreakers online. That is what we want to do in person. So we'll do all the other activities online. And once you do come down on the campus, basically, we'll do the icebreakers over here. And well, let's say that it is somewhere in the month of March or something like that. Okay, so this is how we are planning right now, and things will change as we go along. Some learnings, last one or two slides, very important for the students. You have to make friends, keep parents informed of your academics. This point is still true even though you are at your home. You have to inform your parents about your academics. When you are on the campus, it becomes much more important. When you are on the campus, don't be hurry to go back home after the exam. Avoid temptation to go home during every weekend or festival. In case of success, don't go overboard. In case of failure, please open up with friends. We are there to help you out. Student mentors are there, faculty mentors are there, teachers are there, faculty coordinators, everyone is there to help you out. Don't panic in the current, last point important in the online situation. Don't panic with change in the mode of teaching learning. And when I say that, it's not only online. In general, from your class, from your classes teaching, the different coaching classes teaching to engineering education is a different ballgame again. And perhaps you'll have to read books, you have to take out notes basically, and then do a lot of self-study. So you'll not get the expected questions in general basically, which will come in the exam. Don't get panicked, don't get bogged down. Remember that everyone is in the same boat. As you are, everyone else also is. This is important for parents. Generally, we like to speak to parents on these few points. You should be in touch with your wards on a regular basis. Talk to them about happenings and their feelings. When they are on the campus, it is much more important. Right now, they are with you only. I think those other points were discussed earlier, that you can visit at least once midway during every semester. Parents can be in touch with student mentor and faculty mentor to know the progress basically. And remember, but one thing which needs to be remembered by parents is that your ward is competing now with equals. It's not like up to 12th standard where they were competing with, they were perhaps the first rankers in their class. Now remember that all 900 students are their first rankers in their own classes. Okay, so the relative performance grading might take a hit. But we have to be prepared for that, and that is what the competitive environment is, which will prepare you for the world outside. Parent-child communication goes a long way in maintaining the positive attitude and well-being of the student, that we all know, but it's very, very important. It's again the emphasis getting reinforced every time for us. And now the last point is important right now, because students are with you parents. You have to let students to take initiative now. We are seeing a lot of queries being raised by parents themselves to student mentors. This is not working, that is not working. It's okay, but let students tell them now. They are adults now. They can tell these issues they being faced. So maybe they have to come out of the shell now. This would have been a binary transition if you had come down on the campus. They are completely under your cover. Now they would have been completely on their own. So in a way, it is good that in this pandemic situation, there is a breathing period now where you let them go according to little bit on their way, and keep watch, but don't be interfering about every day, about every class and things like that. And I think that would go a long way in them making a good person. So I think I'm at the end of my presentation. The next part is today's other activity is that BTEC and all BTEC BR students would assemble again at 3 p.m. in online meetings arranged by specific departments, where department introductions would be done by HOD and faculty, and student mentors of the department would interact with you. And you'll be introduced to all the things in the department in the second half. So thank you. Thanks for your time. It's a long session, but we appreciate your patience as well as we thank you. So thanks. Just a minute. There are still 1 or 2 minutes event is remaining. Just hold on for that. Professor Dhabari will take over from this point.
Thank you very much, Professor Keskar. Now it is time to acknowledge the contribution of all in organizing this program and show our gratitude towards them. So first of all, we thank beloved Director Sir, Professor P.M. Padole, for sparing the valuable time from his busy schedule and give us a glimpse into the Institute VNIT. We would like to thank Dean Academic, Professor D.R. Peshwe, for beautifully explaining the academic system in VNIT. We would like to thank Dean Student Welfare, Professor B.S. Umre, to tell about various student activities in VNIT. We would also like to thank Registrar VNIT and all Deans VNIT for their support. We express our gratitude towards Professor D.H. Latte, Dr. Pankaj Dhule, Professor R.B. Keskar, and Mr. Uday Kamath, and members of VNIT Alumni Association for presenting various aspects of VNIT. We thank Ms. Rupali, Ms. Rajni, and Mr. Rakesh from Administrative Office, and Ms. Kritika, Mr. Vijender, and Mr. Mangesh from Network Center VNIT for extending their valuable support in organizing this program. Finally, we would like to thank all others who have extended their help directly or indirectly in organizing this program. We end this program with national anthem. Therefore, I request all to stand at their place for national anthem.
नमनाधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा दारिद्र उत्कल गंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उत्कल जलधि तरंगा सब शुभ नामे जागे सब शुभ आशीष मांगे गावे सब जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय